Namaste, welcome to today's video. Stomach acid, acidity, acid reflux, GERD, these are modern day lifestyle issues that we find it to be very, very common. Okay, which should not be the case because our body is not made to go through all these issues. So we'll try and understand why and what of this. Stomach, our digestion process starts when we break down the food. Okay, the breaking down of food starts in your mouth. Okay, then it gets digested in your stomach, it gets absorbed in your intestine, and then it gets excreted out of the body. Now the major portion of it happens in the stomach, and the stomach breaks down the food through an acid known as hydrochloric acid, which is also known as stomach acid, which in Ayurveda is known as Agni, okay, the digestive fire. And Ayurveda says that as you as the fire diminishes, so is your life. Okay, because we understand that if there is no digestion or proper digestion, you will not get nutrients. Then the cell, the organs, the tissue will not function properly, because food is information. It's a genetic information to our cells. What happens is, as you age, stomach acid, or the ability of our stomach, or the gastrin lining in the stomach, its ability to produce stomach acid goes down. So as we age, our digestion weakens. Okay, and that is the reason people, when they age above 60, the stomach acid, which reduces by 50%, find it hard to eat heavy fat food or a heavy protein food. Okay, because the stomach acid has gone down. Now when the stomach acid goes down, it depletes the body of essential minerals and vitamins, like vitamin B12, even if you eat non-veg. Something like magnesium, it impairs absorption of D3, okay, zinc, calcium, manganese. All these essential minerals and vitamins, are their digestion or absorption is impaired if your stomach acid is low. Okay, now when the stomach acid is low, it can lead to other issues like acid reflux. Yes, acid reflux, or so-called belching, burping, or this burning sensation in your esophagus valve, is not because you got excess acid. It is because there is low acid in your body. Okay, there is something known as Barrett's esophagus. Okay, because our body is so smart that it always tries to support us. So what happens is, if there is a constant burning, okay, or there is constant that mucosal lining, the line that supports our gut, it gets eroded by constant esophagus. What happens is, the brain senses it that here there is a problem. Okay, so it starts to produce the same lining that you have in the stomach. Okay, so the lining here is thin because here the food is just getting swallowed. The lining in the stomach is thickest because that's where it is getting, it is coming in contact with hydrochloric acid. Then the lining in your small intestine is less acidic. It is more alkaline because that's where the absorption will happen. When you are acidic, the absorption does not happen. For absorption to happen, you need to have a slightly alkaline body. And then your rectum or your large intestine are more alkaline for it to move out of the body. Now, when the stomach or the brain senses that constantly there is a burning sensation, there is a reflex, and it is unable to live a normal life, it starts to produce a endothelial lining which is similar to what you have in the stomach. And that's why you got something known as Barrett's esophagus. So basically your stomach is, the lining has moved up, and the body starts to treat this area as a stomach area. This happens in very few cases, but that's how the beauty of our body is. Now what also happens is, whenever the body makes stomach acid, okay, which is hydrochloric acid, and you make around 1 to 3 cups of it in a day, in response to the food, in response to circadian rhythm, in response to your senses, just sight, smell, touch, taste, the body automatically produces stomach acid because it knows, it senses the food is coming and it needs time to prepare itself to digest the food. Now it takes around 15 to 20 minutes for the stomach and the brain to connect and say, yes, I am full, time to stop eating. So if you have a acid reflux problem, first thing you should do is start eating very, very slow. Okay, so your meal should be at least 15, 20 to 30 minutes is the duration that you should take to finish your food. So that means you need to chew properly. You need to take breaks between your bites, relax, deep breathe, maybe have a conversation, which is not a stressful conversation, and eat your food. So people who eat, if you look at traditionally, when people are eating, it's a time when the family gathers and they talk and they focus on good things that happen, because that's the way you extend your eating window or the time to eat. So eating slowly and eating at least for 15 to 20 minutes is a first step if you want to fix your acid reflux or acidity as an issue. Okay. Second is you need to fix your stress. Why? Because stress impairs all digestion. When you're stressed, digestion will not happen. Digestion will not happen, absorption will not happen. Digestion will not happen, body's ability to empty the gastric valve or the stomach will be reduced, because the body is not sensing that the food is digested. The more the food stays beyond a point, it gets fermented, it gets more acidic, and that's where you have reflux. Another thing that causes acid reflux is body being deprived on magnesium. So if your body is low on magnesium, the muscles won't spasm or contract, and if they don't contract, the esophageal sphincter wall opens up, and then you have acid reflux. Acid reflux can also happen because of food sensitivity, okay? If you are sensitive to food, so some people are sensitive to raw tomatoes, lemon, spicy food, pepper, okay, oily and greasy food, okay? So if you have such issues, that can also cause acid reflux. Now, what are the signs of having that, saying that we have low stomach acid? Okay. If you have constant, frequently belching, okay, you feel nauseatic after eating a meal. You feel too full immediately after a meal, and you feel sleepy that you can't open your eyes. Okay. You have IBS or a SIBO, okay, small intestine bacterial overgrowth. That means the digestion which is supposed to happen in the stomach is not happening. It is happening in the small intestine, and hence the bacteria which is there in the large intestine has moved to small intestine because it is getting food there. If you feel fatigued after meals, okay, if you are eating non-veg and you still have low levels of vitamin B12, okay, if your vitamin D3 is low, if your magnesium are low, so if these three things are low or on the lower side, it's a clear indication that your stomach acid is low. If your hair and your nails break easily, okay, if you have chronic allergy, okay, you have multiple mineral deficiencies, so you got your medical test done and it says that you are low on magnesium, zinc, calcium, D3, that's a sign, and B12, that's a sign that your body is low on stomach acid. If you have osteoporosis, okay, you have multiple food allergy or sensitivities, okay, you have chronic indigestion, okay, so these are all signs of that your body is low on stomach acid. Now coming quickly to how you can fix these issues. First, eat slowly, chew your food properly. The more you chew, the better for you, because the digestion starts when you start breaking down the food in your mouth. The fats and the carbs, when they get mixed with saliva, it releases an enzyme amylase, which helps in digestion. Protein is broken down the mouth, goes in the stomach, and pepsin helps in breaking it down further for it to get digested, okay, into amino acids, and then you can digest it. So eat your food slowly. Be mindful. Never eat to a full stomach. Roughly eat around 80% to your stomach capacity. Give some space in the stomach for it to churn, for it to move, for it to create vibration, for it to break it down. If that does not happen, you will have longer duration of food being in your stomach. Okay. There is something known as food grazing. Okay. Wherein people keep on eating food the moment they see something. Okay. Just they put something in their mouth. Okay. Maybe a snack. So stop food grazing. Snack, I think, is one of the biggest blunder of 20th and 21st century, where people started promoting snacks. Okay, so you ate a meal at 1 in the afternoon, and then this 4 o'clock in the evening you're eating a snack. Why? You say, I'm hungry. you're not supposed to be hungry. If your meal is heavy, it's balanced, it has got enough fatty acid, it has got enough protein, it has got sufficient carbs, why would there be an urge that you eat at 1 o'clock and you are eating again at 4 o'clock? Okay, you can also stop stomach issues if you don't drink water along with your meal. Okay, drink sufficient water half an hour before your meal or half an hour after your meal. Okay, throughout the day, keep your hydration level high, but not during the time you're eating meal. A good idea would be never to keep a water jug or a bottle or a glass on your dining table when you're having meal. Yes, it will be uncomfortable for a few days, but once you know it is supporting you, you will definitely come out of it. So in case you are eating too dry food, let's say you're eating a roasted food or something which is spicy and there is a need to have water, a small sip just to support swallowing of food is the best thing. Remember, the only thing that you and I can control voluntarily in a body is the chewing process and the swallowing process. Once it has been swallowed, everything happens automatically. So focus on chewing. Eat slowly. Bite your food at least 20 times, if not more, before you swallow your food. How can you increase your stomach acid? You can increase by taking lemon juice. You can take by taking apple cider vinegar. You can increase by taking ginger. So ginger juice or ginger with lemon juice. It's a very good way to increase stomach acid. In chronic cases, you can take HCl with betaine as a supplement with your meal, but you have to be very, very careful because it causes a lot of burning sensation in a lot of people. Okay. Now, when the body makes stomach acid, it also makes what we call bicarbonate or so-called antacids, because the body always wants to be in balance. So if you eat more or you drink more bicarbonate, which is so-called antacids and fizz and eno to name a few, or digene, because you're saying that it will help me to subside my acid reflux, what you're doing is you're increasing bicarbonate and you're reducing stomach acid, whereas the body always wants it to be in balance. When this goes up, which is the bicarbonate part, the body is becoming, or the stomach is becoming, more alkaline. The more alkaline the stomach is, the lesser stomach acid would be, the higher indigestion or acid reflux you'll have. Okay, bitter herbs, okay, which is like amla, karela, okay, this also helps to increase your stomach acid. Okay, jeera or cumin is a wonderful spice to add in case you want to increase your stomach acid. So the whole problem of acid reflux is not that you got less acid in your body, the more acid in your body. Acid reflux is that you got less acid in your body, and it is because of your lifestyle changes. Fix those lifestyle changes, fix those issues, your reflux will go down. Okay. Yes, in case of gastritis or peptic ulcers, or in case of H. pylori, you can't add ways to increase your stomach acid. You need to consult somebody who follows a protocol of first removing irritants, then adding digestive enzymes, then looking at repairing the lining, and then adding ways to increase your stomach acid. Trust me, chronic cases, anywhere between 30 to 45 days of lifestyle changes can fix these issues for you. Okay. Stomach acid is good for our body. If we do not have sufficient stomach acid, the entire metabolism, the entire methylation, everything gets impaired. And if that gets impaired, the genetic information, the way you are, the way your DNA reacts, everything changes over a period of time. Okay. So focus on it. Give meals enough respect and timing that they need. And with this simple lifestyle changes, you can fix your stomach acid problem. Have a wonderful day, everyone, and we'll catch up soon. Namaste.